Dear friends, today we are discussing about question types. Gathering information is a basic human activity. This information helps us to learn, helps us to solve problems, to make decisions, to understand each other clearly. Okay, how do we gather this information? We gather information by asking questions. Questioning is the key to gain more information, and without it, interpersonal communication can fail. It is fundamental to successful communication. We all ask and are asked questions when engaged in conversation. The answers will be vary. It depends upon one's purposes. We ask questions to obtain information. The primary function of a question is to gain information and to help maintain control of a conversation. Express an interest in the other person. Means questioning allows to build rapport and show empathy, or to simply get to know the other person better. To clarify a point, questions are commonly used in communication to clarify something that the speaker has said. It will help to reduce misunderstanding, and there's a chance of more effective communication also. To explore the personality and or difficulties the other person may have. Questions help to explore the feelings, beliefs, opinions, ideas, and attitudes of the person being questioned. We can better understand problems that another person may be experiencing, like in the example of a doctor trying to diagnose a patient. To test knowledge, questions are used in all sorts of cues, test, and exam situations to ascertain the knowledge of the respondent. To encourage further thought, questions may be used to encourage people to think about something more deeply. In group situations, example for a classroom situation, it helps to encourage more discussions of a point, to keep attention by asking questions without advance warning. Well, students, now let us watch a video about the power of effective questioning.
And by his questions rather than his answers. And he makes a very good point. It's often said that the quality of your life is defined by the questions you ask, because the quality of the question determines the quality of the answer. So it stands to reason that if you can get better at asking questions, then you can get better answers. Better answers result in a whole host of benefits. For example, being better informed allows you to make better decisions. But being better at answering questions doesn't just mean getting better answers. Obtaining information is just one outcome of questioning. Questions can be used for controlling a conversation. This can be particularly useful during an argument or negotiation. Questions can also be used as a way of showing interest. Showing an interest in other people can help to build relationships, and showing an interest in a subject can open up opportunities to become involved. What's more, questions can be used to explore people's personalities or to diagnose problems, as well as being the common way of testing people's knowledge, such as exam questions. Questions can also be used to encourage further thought or used to emphasize a point. For example, this could be done using a rhetorical question. Finally, ever heard of an icebreaker? Well, questions can be used to encourage a discussion amongst a group and promote conversation amongst people who don't know each other. So it's worth considering how skilled you are at asking questions, because although we all know how to ask a question, do we all know how to do it properly? Questions in their simplest form can either be open or closed. Closed questions are questions which require a short answer, often one word, and chosen from a limited set of possible answers. For example, yes or no questions, or multiple choice questions, or a question to get a specific piece of information. Let's look at some examples of closed questions. Would you like an ice cream? What flavor would you like? How much does it cost? In contrast, open questions allow for much longer responses and therefore potentially more creativity and information. An open question asks the respondent for his or her knowledge, opinion, or feelings about something, and the response is usually more qualitative than quantitative. They usually begin with what, why, or how, but tell me and describe can also be used in the same way. Here are some examples of open questions. Tell me what happened when your ice cream was stolen. Why did you not report it right away? How was your day out at the seaside? There are a few advanced questioning techniques, such as leading questions, probing questions, funneling, and rhetorical questions. Let's now take a look at how they work. Simply put, leading questions are where you lead the respondent towards giving you a particular answer which is more favorable to you. For example, if a salesperson asks you, "How many widgets do you want?" then the salesperson has assumed you want some. To answer the question with a number means you've been led to an outcome. However, you must use leading questions with caution because they can be interpreted as rude and manipulative. Probing questions are questions which force the respondent to think more deeply about the information they recall for their answer. For example, if you use a word like "exactly" in the question, it forces the respondent to be specific. Funneling questions allow you to cleverly funnel the respondent's answers. You do this by asking a series of questions that become more or less restrictive at each step. You start with open questions and end using closed questions, or vice versa. For example, "Have you been to any good parties recently?" "What did you do at the party?" "Was any food provided?" "Did you eat jelly?" The questions in the example become more restrictive, starting with open questions which allow very broad answers, and at each step the questions become more focused and the answers become more restrictive. Rhetorical questions are often characterized by being questions which do not require an answer. Sometimes the question is unanswerable, but usually the answer is obvious. So obvious, in fact, that you wouldn't answer it. It has been asked to demonstrate a point and said for effect. Okay. Do you want to know a secret skill about questioning that is left out of many courses? It's the importance of silence. When you ask a question, no matter how awkward you feel, try to be quiet and let the other person answer. As we've just discussed, unless you're asking a rhetorical question, the purpose of a question is to receive an answer. So be sure to give the respondent the time to answer. And while we are talking about responses, how you interpret the response is equally important to the question. For example, you could ask the best question in the world, but if the answer is a lie or you don't get an answer, what good was the question? Watch out for respondents who only partially answer your questions or stall when responding. Politicians are well known for avoiding the question by giving an unrelated answer. So consider what type of response you are expecting and have a suitable method for making a record of the answer.
The first and famous one of method of questioning is Socratic method. We all know who was Socrates. He was the greatest philosopher and considered one of the greatest and most important philosophers who ever lived, and left no writings at all. Most of what we know about him, his life and works, from his disciples Xenophon and Plato. Socrates engaged in questioning of his students in an unending search for truth. Socratic method of questioning is a dialectic method of inquiry. To solve a problem, it should be broken down into a series of questions. The answers to these questions would help one to discover the answers they are seeking. The questions help one understand their underlying beliefs and the extent of their knowledge. It is a negative method of idea elimination by identifying ideas that led to contradictions, used in courtrooms today. Socratic method is disciplined questioning that can be used to pursue thought in many directions and for many purposes, including to explore complex ideas, to get the truth of the things, to open up issues and problems, to uncover assumptions, to analyze concepts, and to distinguish what we know from and what we do not know. Socratic questioning is a systematic, disciplined, deep, and usually focuses on the fundamental concepts, principles, theories, issues, and problems. In teaching, teachers can use Socratic questioning for at least two purposes. One is to deeply probe student thinking. It helps students to begin to distinguish what they know or understand from what they do not know or understand. Next one is to foster students' abilities to ask Socratic questions, to help students acquire the powerful tools of Socratic dialogue so that they can use these tools in everyday life. Now let us watch a video about Socratic type of questioning.
Socratic questioning, or Socratic maieutics, is disciplined questioning that can be used to pursue thought in many directions and for many purposes, including to explore complex ideas, to get to the truth of things, to open up issues and problems, to uncover assumptions, to analyze concepts, to distinguish what we know from what we don't know, to follow out logical implications of thought, or to control the discussion. The key to distinguishing Socratic questioning from questioning per se is that Socratic questioning is systematic, disciplined, deep, and usually focuses on fundamental concepts, principles, theories, issues, or problems. Socratic questioning is referred to in teaching and has gained currency as a concept in education, particularly in the past 2 decades. Teachers, students, or anyone interested in probing thinking at a deep level can construct Socratic questions and engage in these questions. Socratic questioning and its variants has also been extensively used in psychotherapy. When teachers use Socratic questioning in teaching, their purpose may be to probe student thinking, to determine the extent of student knowledge on a given topic, issue, or subject, to model Socratic questioning for students, or to help students analyze a concept or line of reasoning. It is suggested that students should learn the discipline of Socratic questioning so that they begin to use it in reasoning through complex issues, in understanding and assessing the thinking of others, and in following out the implications of what they and others think. In fact, Socrates himself thought that questioning was the only defensible form of teaching. In teaching, teachers can use Socratic questioning for at least 2 purposes. 1. To deeply probe student thinking, to help students begin to distinguish what they know or understand from what they do not know or understand, and to help them develop intellectual humility in the process. 2. To foster students' abilities to ask Socratic questions, to help students acquire the powerful tools of Socratic dialogue, so that they can use these tools in everyday life, in questioning themselves and others. To this end, teachers can model the questioning strategies they want students to emulate and employ. Moreover, teachers need to directly teach students how to construct and ask deep questions. Beyond that, students need practice to improve their questioning abilities. Socratic questioning has also been used in therapy, most notably as a cognitive restructuring technique in cognitive therapy, logotherapy, and classical Adlerian psychotherapy. The purpose here is to help uncover the assumptions and evidence that underpin people's thoughts in respect of problems. A set of Socratic questions in cognitive therapy to deal with automatic thoughts that distress the patient. 1. Revealing the issue: what evidence supports this idea? And what evidence is against its being true? 2. Conceiving reasonable alternatives: what might be another explanation or viewpoint of the situation? Why else did it happen? 3. Examining various potential consequences: what are worst, best, bearable, and most realistic outcomes? 4. Evaluate those consequences: what's the effect of thinking or believing this? What could be the effect of thinking differently and no longer holding on to this belief? 5. Distancing: imagine a specific friend/family member in the same situation, or if they view the situation this way, what would I tell them? Careful use of Socratic questioning enables a therapist to challenge recurring or isolated instances of a person's illogical thinking while maintaining an open position that respects the internal logic to even the most seemingly illogical thoughts.
Okay, students, let us discuss about convergent and divergent questions. Convergent and divergent questions. Convergent is a question that encourages students' responses to focus on a central theme. It can be divided into 2, closed and open questions. There are 2 definitions that are used to describe closed questions. A common definition is: a closed question can be answered with either a single word or a short phrase. A closed question can be answered with either yes or no. Closed questions have the following characteristics: they give you facts, they are easy to answer, They are quick to answer. They keep control of the conversation with questionnaire. An open question can be defined. An open question is likely to receive a long answer. Open questions have the following characteristics. They ask the respondent to think and reflect. They will give you opinions and feelings. They hand control of the conversation to the respondent. Divergent questions, on the other hand, stimulate student creative or critical thinking, encouraging students to be better observers. These open-ended questions can guide students as they discover information for themselves, analyze data, make inferences, and identify relationships. Convergent versus divergent questions. Examples of convergent questions and divergent questions are given here. How many of the pilgrims who sailed on the Mayflower survived the first winter? Which is smaller, 5 by 16 or 3 by 8? Is salt water denser than fresh water? These are the examples of convergent questions. Then examples of divergent questions are, what do you predict will happen? What can you tell me about shadows? What sacrifices made by